Hey guys, dueling contracts is what our topic is. But first, before we go over that, let's talk about our new website. As you can see, Blair Cato has a new logo colors and we have a new website. Put a lot of thought in this and a lot of things that we thought you would like to see. As you can see on our homepage, we have our podcast. We also have our 400 five-star reviews. So if your client wants to know more about us, tell them just to go to our website and check that out. You also can hit on the chat box here. Alana will come up 24/7 and answer a lot of your questions about your closing. In fact, if you check on the box, click on the box and then just type in, what can you do or what can you tell me? Alana will tell you what she can do. You also have a realtor resource page now. On the resource page, a lot of the things that you need to see. We have information here on how to deposit earnest money with a law firm using Zocum. Here's a great breakthrough broker program, which we set up for you for free, which is a great marketing piece that you can use. And it's got all kind of great marketing in it that's done for free. Alana's how to talk with us 24/7 and continuing education classes we're offering through CCRA. We also created a seller page. So if you have a seller that's doing for sale by owner and you don't want to give them the information, you send them here. And there's an hour-long podcast on how to sell the house by themselves. In the first part, we do talk strongly about and suggest strongly that they should be using a realtor and not trying this on their own. But it does go through the process. And quite frankly, I think it should scare them a little bit and not doing it with an agent. Seller disclosure, no representation, podcast, as well as disclosure statements. They can get a copy of them. We also have our legal tips, and we also have a podcast link here. We have a link for our previous articles that we wrote many years ago. Under our legal tips, these are the legal tips like this one right here. You're getting, I think we have 12 or 15 of the most popular ones that we have right in here. You also have the most important one, which is the 4% versus 6% tax rate. So if your clients have questions about that, they can look at that. So a lot of great things for your client. Now, the first question or the question of the day is dueling contracts. Rosie is a great agent, always responds and looks at, watches our videos. She asked me, she said she saw something in MLS where somebody, an agent comment said, well, only accept contracts on CCR, not on CCRA, but we'll only accept state contracts. She said, is that even legal? And my answer to that is no, not really. And the reason it's not is you have a duty to present all, and that's the keyword, all contracts and all offers to your seller. You don't get to present the ones that you like on the form they come in. You can't present just the ones that you like the price or the ones that you just like the terms. Your job and your law and your requirements is you must present every single offer you get to your client. That's it. Bottom line. So you can't tell other agents not to submit me an offer on CCRA. They can submit you an offer on a napkin if they want to, and you must present it as long as it's contract. You must present that to your client. So no, don't put that in there. Now, this is also different, though. Keep it understand that your seller may decide they don't want to accept a particular type of form contract, such as a builder. They have their own contracts and they can do that. But again, if somebody gives you a contract and you represent a seller and it's written on a state form, you still have to present that to your seller. Your seller builder can say, hey, I'm not going to respond to that. Put it on our contract form or send our contract form over and tell them to do it on ours. It's your client's decision. But don't pull this crap and say, well, I put that in the remarks because my client said they don't want the CCRA contract or they don't want the state contract, because your clients don't know the difference between them. There's no way, unless your client's a lawyer or your client's a real estate agent, they're not going to know we even have dueling contracts in the state. So, again, present all contracts. I don't buy this crap where my clients made that decision. If you get a contract on a form that's not the form you normally use in your market, you need to present it. And then you can explain to your client, hey, I think we should counter back on CCRA. And this is why, which is point number two, not accepting a contract or not using the contract in your own market is stupid. Because everybody in your market knows your contract, whether it's the lenders, the attorneys, the inspection companies, the appraisers, they all know our contract in the Midlands at CCRA. Those in other parts of the state know the contract as a state contract. They know what their duties are. They know their timeframes. So why in the world would you bring in a contract that your vendors don't use on a regular basis? So it makes no sense. That's why CCRA and the state board allow you to use the contract, even if you're not a member in that market, with their permission. So you should be using the contract in your marketplace. That's the contract you should do. I don't care that you don't like it. That's the one you should be using, because that's the one that everybody else is using and that's the one everybody else understands. So we don't want to get in a situation where we don't understand each other's terms. So no, it's illegal for you to refuse to present the contract. And I also think it's just bad business to be using a contract that's not being used in the marketplace. Hope that helps, everybody. Hope y'all enjoy our legal tips and we hope you enjoy our new website.